Hi there, Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and today I'm going to show you how to use the month function in Excel 2016. Now let's look at the month function. Equals month, and it's going to prompt us for the serial number. And the month function will return a number between 1 and 12, the numbering of that month. So what can we do with this? Over here I have today, which is another function which returns today's date. And I'm going to put in equals month left parenthesis, and I'm going to reference this cell, right parenthesis, enter, and I get 1. I know that 1 is the number of the month currently. Going down here, what exactly is a serial number? Well, let's look at that. A serial number can be one of many things. Right here we have the same data, just formatted differently. I have a long date, I have a actual serial number, which I'll get to in a second, and we have a formatted short date. I can put all of these into the month function and get 1. So regardless of how my data is formatted, I will still get the same result with this function. Moving on here, let's explain what the serial number means. Well, the serial number is the days after January 1st, 1900. I don't know why, this is just how Excel counts its days. It has to do math with days, and it can't really do math with a number that is formatted with slashes. It'll look at that and think, oh, I have to divide 4 with 16 with 2018, and you'll get some weird result. Don't believe me, just try it. Equals month, and try to put in the day, 01/18/2018. You get 1. But what it won't show you is, let's change that month to 12, and we still get 1. That's not quite correct. It is actually evaluating that as a math problem now, which we do not want to do. This will return a small number, and Excel will see, oh, that's the first month, because it's probably January something of 1900. That's not quite correct. So always be sure, if you are going to put in dates into the month function, put them in quotes. So now I have 1/1/2018. We're going to make that 12. Just make sure you put your end quote. And what do we have? We have 12 now. Here I have a list of dates. And as you can see, as the year progresses, it continuously adds to these dates. Let's move over here to an example of how we can use the month function in our spreadsheets. Here I have a list of people who sold cars at a car dealership, and I have, you know, the prices and the dates. I want to sort this out, and maybe I have the question of how many cars did we sell in December and who sold them. Well, I can put in the month function, equals month left parenthesis, reference this date right parenthesis. It returns me 10. I can look at that and say, oh yes, it's October over there, so it should be October over here. I'm gonna drag that down, fill in my table, and now we can see values are all down there. At this point, I'm going to make my data into a table. My table has headers, and I can sort the month. So I'm deselect all and scroll down to 12, only show me 12, and there we go. I can see that two cars were sold in December, and I can change this around every month past July. And what do I have? I have this. Well, actually, July is included, but you get the point. I can use this month function to sort and filter out my data. I'm Josh here with Evergreen Tutorials, and we've gone over the month function in Excel 2016. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, and we'll get back to you. If you like this video, please subscribe for other educational content. We release videos daily, and I'd like to thank you for watching. Have a nice day.